guys, it's me, Sabrina, again, here for another video. How you been? So, keto update time. Of course, it's Saturday when I'm filming this, so I always weigh myself on Saturdays. So, last week I weighed in at 200.3 pounds. Super excited. Yes, I was. And it was a carb day, so that was even more exciting than the 3 pound weight loss I had last week. But this week I weighed in at 205.7. Yes, 205.7. Now there's a lot of reasons why this probably happened. It's a 5.4 pound weight gain this week. So let me give you all the reasons why this probably happened to me, so you can avoid those. So last week, like I said, was a carb day for me. I don't do carb meals. I do carb days. I find that it helps me get through the next 3 weeks not to do just a meal. I take a full day. That's just me. You can choose to do a meal, but I take a full day. So normally when I do a carb day, I try to eat high carb meals. So I'll actually sit down to a full meal, whether that's Chinese, Indian, I make something at home. I do West Indian food that I grew up with and love so dearly. And normally the next day I will just be still so full. It's not that I'm not hungry. I'm just so full still that I have no desire to eat whatsoever. And I can normally go for the majority of the day without any food. So normally around 3-4 o'clock is when I say, I should probably eat something. And so that's how I'm used to doing my carb days. But this time, I fell back into some bad habits. So a lot of my weight gain can be attributed to my previous eating habits. So normally, before I started on the keto diet, anything like this, I am a big fan of snacking. I love snacking. Whether it's on chips or cookies or whatever, I love snacking. I love the convenience of that action. It's great. I love it. But what happens is that I snack all day and then don't feel satisfied. So I end up eating a big meal really late, and that's what really kind of contributed to my previous weight gain in general. That eating habit doesn't really work for me. So on Saturday, my carb day, I did the exact same thing that I used to do. I bought lots of little cookies, little chips, all that kind of stuff, because I couldn't figure out what I really wanted. So I bought a lot of little packages and was just snacking through the day. Then all of a sudden, 8 o'clock reached and I am just so doggone tired that I pretty much just passed out that night. I did, passed out. I couldn't stay awake anymore. I had tears rolling down my face. It was crazy. You know, for my sister, she always gets super tired on carb days. Me, normally not so much, but this time I was exhausted. But the next day, I woke up starving. I woke up so hungry. And that was really odd for me. Second thing to mention at this time is that I didn't actually finish all of the food that I had purchased for my carb day Saturday. So imagine I'm waking up starving and there's still cookies and chips there that are open. And because I, at heart, am a frugalist person, I thought I spent money on that food. So that food should be eaten, because in 3 weeks, that's going to be stale as hell. That's a part of my reasoning now that I'm not starving, but at that time, it was an idea far back in my mind, but really I was just hungry. I was hungry and I was not in the mood for no tea for the morning, nothing like that. I wanted food. So that's what I ended up doing. I ended up taking a second carb day. I know, so bad. I wanted it. And I can't say, even now, having seen the weight gain, that I am sad about that or I regret that decision at all. It felt amazing to take a second day. It did. I'll be completely honest with you. Even with the weight gain, I don't regret taking that second carb day. I needed that. My soul needed that second carb day. Someone took it. Obviously, that impacted my weight gain for this week. Also, I can give you all the other standard excuses. My time of the month is due any day now. So I normally don't have a loss or something. You see a slight gain normally, even if I've done my carb days correctly. There's always a little kind of something there when, you know, Shark Week is looming. So that's also a part, but I will totally take the fall for this weight gain. I took a second carb day and I pigged out last weekend, but I am reaffirming my values in sticking with keto for the next 3 weeks so that I can take a carb day for my sister's birthday, and I've got a big surprise for her. I'm not telling her what it is, so I can't tell you guys because there is a chance that she might watch this video and I don't want to ruin the surprise. But it will be tasty. That's all I can say. It's going to be awesome. I can't wait for that particular carb day. Otherwise, obviously this is a setback for me. I was so close to Wonderland, but obviously I didn't make it this week, but you know what? That's okay. And I just want to send a message to everyone else who may be watching this. Setbacks happen. There's nothing you can do about it. Just because the scale hasn't moved in the direction that you kind of wanted it to does not mean that you're doing it wrong and that you should just fall back on bad habits. Not the way. Not the way. So what I do in these setback moments is I look for the small victories. You know, I've got better energy. My skin, for the most part, is so much better. I'm always getting complimented all of a sudden from people who see me regularly. Oh my God, you're looking so skinny. I'm like, thank you. Thank you. I am skinnier. So take it as it is. It's just a week. It's just a scale. It's just a number on a scale that should not really make or break your day. So that's it for this week. If you have any questions, please put them down below. And there will be more content next week. Continue on this journey with me. Until next time.